change had much to say. But man, I still think them cats are crazy. They were asking if you were around, how you was, where you could be found. I told them you were living downtown.
She's all pregnant.
Now presenting the Luke and Lewis podcast.
Can you hit the intro music, please? And then we'll come in.
Yeah! Woo! Yeah! We have returned! Back in studio!
Stay the fuck away from me.
Don't
cough on me.
Mate.
I've sanitized this microphone beforehand. Mm-hmm. Don't touch it.
Okay, I'm not going to touch it, but I saw you for lunch, right? Eating something that I don't approve of. Okay? We've spent over 100 days in fucking quarantine, and you show up, first thing you do is pull out a bat soup.
Yes.
And that's... Where the fuck do you even get that?
I thought for a second you were about to have a go at me for eating an apple just before the show. I was like, whoa, why do you hate apples so much? What's your problem? I was like, Reuben was fucking eating one too.
Yeah, well, I'm upset about that because I felt really left out. There was no apple for me.
We were having a team crunch.
I didn't organize one.
Then Lewis just accused me of eating a bat. Which I was.
Yeah, he was. It wasn't, you know, and it's an accusation, but sometimes those are true. You know, that accusation has got a dirty name because of Twitter, but sometimes they are true.
Yes.
And Luke Higgell was eating bat soup before we start recording.
Cancel me.
Yeah.
Cancel bats while you're at it.
Welcome back to the studio, guys. How good is it to be in the studio?
It's good to be back, and we may have a few new viewers back, hopefully.
Yeah.
I think a lot of people are almost like us, threw in the towel on the Zoom episodes.
Not going to lie, the last episode that we recorded over Zoom was a real big indicator of our mental state and the amount of effort going into the show because we weren't in the same room. It's all over, guys. We're back in. It's gonna be picking up.
I like to imagine that would have been an actual argument in Parliament as to, like, you know, people arguing for people's mental health. We need to open up. And they're like, well, do you have any evidence? And they just show 10 minutes of Ewan Killen laughing at Scooby-Doo. And Daniel Andrews is like, God, it's getting bad out there. We need to open up. And we're back. So there will be... limited to no Scooby-Doo chat.
Mm-hmm. Well, you brought it to the show straight away.
That's fine.
Okay.
Killen's not here. Killen was definitely the instigator of it, and you're enabling it.
Yeah, I was.
If
absolutely.
None of us instigate it, then it's fine.
You know what is really, really frustrating? I think we can all agree, Ruben as well, I think we'd all agree, I'd say the last 60 days of the show would have to be our lowest quality episodes yet. I think they weren't bad.
No.
But in terms of stuff that we've done, I think that we personally think that we could definitely do a lot better.
I think, put it this way, I think we had maybe 5 to 8 stinkers in the first 80 episodes.
Yeah.
But
then
throughout quarantine, I think we had 5 to 8 good episodes in the next 80 kind of thing.
Would you agree, Ruben?
I would agree, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, we're only up to 130.
Yeah. 125. So I would like us... you know, to just really brace yourself for some terrible news. I'm very sad to report that the last 30 days of the show have been the most popular that it has ever been. It's the biggest by far that the show has ever been. And in our opinion, the worst it's ever been. So I think that's a really bad sign of things to come because we think the quality is going to pick up. So as the quality increases now that we're back in studio, the listeners are going to...
I think we were talking on the phone a couple of days ago and I was going through some of the comments. I hadn't been through a comment section in a while, one of our sound-off sections, and it was below the last Scooby-Doo episode. And I think I remember actually saying the phrase to you, why the fuck do we even bother? Because we that episode, I will be quite honest with you all, we didn't bother.
Oh, no.
But yet no one cared. If anything, when we put effort into the episode, people were like, oh, not your best one.
Yeah.
Or, you know, that park episode... was so much effort to try and pull off.
So difficult.
Technically and also content-wise because there was a lot of distractions and noise around us.
Yeah.
And our people like, oh, not your best boys.
We were really proud of that one too.
Yeah. You know?
We got to the end of it. We were like, guys, you were like, man, we have to do this once a week at least.
Well, because I didn't know like how long we'd be still in lockdown for at the time. Yeah, so I was like, yeah, I definitely think this is doable.
You know why we opened up, right? Because Daniel Andrews heard there was going to be a once a week Luke and Lewis Park episode yeah. and he thought, fuck the virus, open it up.
Yeah, he was like, I'm pretty sure our editor was pretending to be a bird. Let's fucking open up. This was bad.
Yeah.
So we're back and...
I have an issue that right off the bat that needs to be addressed.
Okay.
We all said in the group chat yesterday, this is the first time we've been back. Keelan is not with us because he's in Canberra, right? So we're one man down. So we're short staffed. We also have to reset up the studio to make it look nice.
Should I read out what Keelan texted me as soon as he got to Canberra?
What did he text you?
Is that inappropriate?
Well, the fact that you asked me that question means that yes, it's very fucking inappropriate.
Should have asked our HR department beforehand.
She usually says yes to everything.
I'll retrospectively run it by her when I get home.
That's good. Okay, so well, you let me know if this is work safe or not after the fact, after we put it out publicly.
Do you remember
everywhere.
When Radio Mike back in the day used to? There was one time he called me saying,
"For fuck's sake,"
that I was speaking to a freshly cummed Mike.
Yeah,
after he just had
a root
intercourse. Yeah, Keelan, obviously, his girlfriend lives in Canberra. They've been apart for a long time. He'd been there for, I reckon, 20 minutes. Like, I knew what time his flight was, and then the time that I received the text was impressive.
Impressive or disappointing, depending on who you are. Maybe impressive for us. For Phoebe, maybe a bit disappointing.
Yeah, disappointing for Phoebe. Yeah. Very impressive for Keelan, I guess. He won, for sure.
Yeah.
He just texts me out of the blue, no context. I'm at FCK, and then ... freshly cummed Keel.
Great. That is disgusting, and that is. I know our HR department might clear it, but has she done any kind of HR training?
Mate, don't look into it. All right, you're going to get buried in paperwork, and yeah, it's not going to go well
can't
for us.
Bothered. As a business. That's HR department's problem anyway.
Yeah,
and I'm sure they're all properly trained.
Go celebrate that FCK with a KFC.
Same letters.
Yes,
that's great. Bringing back to Keelan putting inappropriate stuff out there. His close friend's story was fucking disgusting the day beforehand. Did you see this, Ruben?
No.
He's not a close friend.
I might not be.
Have you ever seen a close friend's story of Keelan's?
Yeah,
no,
regularly.
Well, to be honest, I'd probably just avoid Keelan's stories. It would probably make more sense.
That is good. Well, at least you guys are both on the same page.
Well, this is what you're missing.
Yeah.
Yeah, Keelan posting, this was the day before, so this is like 11 p.m. at night before he's supposed to get on a plane at 5 a.m. Him just drinking a 2-liter pineapple juice and going, I'm seeing Phoebe tomorrow, lol.
Gross.
Disgusting.
Well...
And then we're in the Patreon free time voice chat Discord, and he's posting it there. So I call him out in front of all the patrons. I say, that's disgusting. Why are you posting that? Won't Phoebe get mad? And then he goes, nah, man, all good. Posts another one, tags her in it. and then the next one, he posts a screenshot of her love heart reacting it. So good on him.
It had been a while.
Yeah.
And that's when I knew, like, when he texted me, like, freshly calmed, I was like, oh, definitely was fresh. Which is good.
That's disgusting. Now, Luke. Well,
something's come up. This is what you're originally going
to
say.
Yeah, we're all, look, well, I know we're having a good time. We want to do a good episode here, but I feel like this does need to be addressed.
I don't think it needs to be
Well, I think that it does. And obviously, as I was saying, Keelan's gone. We're a man down. Yep. We're coming back into the studio. We're doing a multicam setup. We want it to look nice and good. And we want it to make...
Back.
It's back. Yeah. We need to make a good first impression, and that takes time, okay? Yep. How long do you think it's taken us to set up, Ruben?
Just doing some quick calculations, almost 4 hours.
4 hours, okay, of setup. So we all agreed last night that we would get here at 10 a.m., okay?
Well, no, I agreed with you
yeah.
on the phone, 10 a.m.,
yeah.
And then we're not very good bosses, and we didn't tell Ruben, who was the only one coming in today, what time to get here. He then messages the group chat at about 11 p.m., you're probably in bed.
Yeah.
My sleep pattern's fucked, so I'm probably having breakfast at this point. and he goes, so 11 tomorrow? And I go, well, that sounds a lot better than 10. I go, yeah, 11. And then He goes, oh, no, wait, we do have a lot of stuff to do. First day back, there might be some...
Responsible employee.
Right? Yes. And then he talks me back down to a 10 a.m. I was ready to message you going, hey, change of plans. We'll be there
at 11. Yeah, but the problem with those fucking change of plans is you always make them at 11:30. I'm in bed. And you go, hey, mate, is 2 p.m. in 3 days all good? Yeah. I want to sleep in for 3 days. Mm-hmm. And then I'll wake up at like 7 a.m. ready for 10 a.m. and yeah. I'll read that and I'll go, for fuck's sake.
Well, that's where I make most of my decision making, after midnight.
Yeah.
And that's not my fault that you're not on my schedule. Well, get on my schedule.
No, okay, you need to get on a normal person's schedule because you, today, after we all agreed 10 a.m., we're late. And I don't want to start this off on a negative tone, but I'm very angry at you for being late because it sets a bad precedent. We're trying to come back and impress the listeners and you show up late. Okay. So... what's going on?
Hear me out.
Yeah.
We all know, okay, and in the past, mm-hmm. if the old listeners of the show back when we're in the studio, some new people might have come in over the COVID period. Thank you. But if you don't know.
We will disappoint you. There's not much Scooby-Doo stuff.
Yeah. there's been a direct correlation in the past with me being late and Ruben being 100% responsible for that. Hasn't there?
Yeah. Very strong correlation. Yes.
Who did I travel in with today, Lewis?
Can you turn your phone
Jesus
off?
Jesus Christ. That's
We're
so
talking about you.
Sorry.
That was so loud.
Yeah. We're talking about you, mate. Uh-huh. And you're on thin ice after that. You know, Luke, sounds like Luke's going to bring up some damning evidence here. And you've got your phone on. I thought you respected this show.
I do. I have the utmost respect for this
act
show.
Act like it, all right?
I'm sorry.
You're in Keelan's role now, so you can cop it.
Technically, I think Ruben, at least in the group chat last night, respected the show a lot more than I, because I was really arguing to come in at 11.
Mm.
And he was like, imagine like in any other workplace, an employee trying to convince their boss to come in early. Come on, we have a bunch of stuff to do.
On time. Which, by the way, 10 a.m. is a late start anyway. Most of these other people have to get there at 8:30 to be ready by 9. We get here at 10 to be ready by fucking 3.
Fucking Frankston, I'm not going to wake up before 8. Anyway, that's not why I signed up. I didn't go to uni. Well, sorry, I didn't drop out of uni to then wake up at 8. If I wanted to drop out of uni, whatever.
Anyway. I had to do so much convincing.
Mate, you couldn't even finish that sentence. It's a wonder you got into uni.
I didn't. I lied. It was tape. Yeah. Anyways, it was a bachelor's course out of tape. It was not uni.
Yeah.
Anyway.
What were you saying?
I just had to do so much convincing to get Luke to agree to 10.
By the way, he already agreed with me to do. So.
No, but as soon as you said 11, I went, I didn't even think of 11.
It's a whole new world.
It's like I could have an extra hour of sleep, and this is amazing.
Yeah. So you were late.
Well, okay. So
why were you late?
I originally posted in the group chat about 10 minutes before I was about to leave, going, guys, no surprises. Ruben's made me bloody late again.
He made you late.
Well, and you already said you were like, of course, classic Ruben.
Well, Ruben does seem to do that a lot. Like, it had happened a lot before you guys started carpooling, but when you and Ruben started carpooling together, that continued.
That was being punctual.
The only logical answer is that Ruben's made it worse.
Yes. So then I get out to my car and I try and open it with like my keys, and then I realize the central locking is not working, like the button.
Well, hang on a second.
No.
You sound like you're already late before Ruben comes into the picture.
So what time
I'm all
that?
For blaming Ruben. However, at this point...
No, but you've already agreed in the group chat at this point that Ruben's responsible for me being late.
But all I had was Ruben's made me late again. If you said, hey, boys, haven't seen Ruben yet, but he's made me late.
I'll be honest, slept in a little late because Ruben was bloody arguing with me for ages about what time we should come in or not.
You can't keep Luke up late if he has to wake up early in the morning, mate. You know that.
Okay, I won't do that again, I guess.
And that means I have to push back my Halo sesh until like 1 a.m. Because I was busy talking to you at a reasonable hour.
When did you go to bed last night?
Don't get into the nitty gritty.
Because I won't be the first one to say it. In fact, I think you were the first one to say it today when we arrived. Now, you have a great haircut. You've got a brand new haircut, but still, you look like shit. So, what have you done last? When did you go to bed?
I went to bed at 1:30 a.m.
That's a bit early for you.
But I was gonna say, because I knew I had an early start, I don't think I got to sleep till about 2 because my sleeping patterns cooked. I did stream until 4 a.m. on Friday night.
What are you doing?
I was playing
Who the fuck was watching that?
It was like 80 people.
Hey, go to bed. Who the fuck?
Oh, no, no. By the end, after like three, there was like 50 people still watching.
50 people? What are you doing?
I know, I was playing Need for Speed and I was on like, you know, when you get like stuck in a cop chase.
You get any pink slips?
Yeah, I got like two pink slips and I was trying to be the next Blacklist member. Should've watched it. But yeah, speaking of me just looking like shit, just a bit of a detour.
Yeah.
Brutal, brutal comment the other day. Friend of the show, Rory Lowe, Perth comedian.
Yeah. Unfortunately.
Yeah, yeah. He just comments, oh, fuck. I hate coming to Frankston. Doesn't work. Anyway, it was something along the lines of...
You don't have a memory?
Yeah, I'll paraphrase. I'll paraphrase. Yeah. It was something along the lines of like, hey, mate, just letting you know, I've drunk every day for the last 4 years and you look like shit. He was like, compared to me, you still look like shit.
Yeah.
And I was just like, that is the ultimate wake-up call. Mm. When someone from Perth tells you you look like shit,
yeah,
you need to start going to bed earlier. And I was literally on my stream at 4 a.m. going, guys, I think I'm done. I think this is like the final hurrah and it's no longer fun for me.
Yeah.
I'm tired and I've started pulling it back. I went to 2 o'clock the night after, then 1:30 last night. Try and go 1 tonight.
Okay.
I'm trying to pull it back slowly.
All right. Well, so what you're saying is, you know, by Wednesday, by the next time we record in a few days, you'll be on time for sure.
Unless Ruben fucks up again. But anyway, so I get up.
Well, hey, we still haven't gotten to the point where Ruben is still not involved at all. And
he's already making me late because
I wasn't there.
But I'm up all night.
You were messaging him at night. Yeah.
So
no, I would say I screwed up his sleep schedule.
Of course.
Maybe. Yeah.
Thank you for admitting fault.
But did you after you messed with his sleep schedule, did you come into the house and smash his alarm?
No.
Oh, well then why?
I just forgot to do the dishes. So I had to like wash a bunch of stuff this morning if I wanted to eat.
You live in the 18th century. You got no dishwasher.
No, I know.
You're probably out there on your fucking clothesline paddling the carpet because you can't wash that.
The guy was booked in to come to our house and then the second lockdown hit. So I've been trying to get a dishwasher for a year now and COVID's fucked it. It's rough. There's a dishwasher waiting at this our landlord's house. Anyway, it's a whole thing. So, I was running a little late. Like,
I knew it!
But,
yeah,
right? I think this is where Ruben comes in. Mm-hmm. But I messaged the group chat. I've already blamed Ruben. I'm off the hook at this stage. I'm cruising.
Yeah.
Then I try and unlock my car. It's not working. I go to Ruben. I'm like, dude, my car's not opening. And he thinks I'm bullshitting. He's like, are you serious? I'm like, I swear to God, I can't even get in my car. Yeah. It sounds made up. It sounds like the dog ate my homework.
That's your problem though, because you are late so often that you probably used up all your real sounding reasons.
But you true. But if I was late, I'd try and come up with something more creative than that. And you can't predict your car not opening. I'm not allowing time for that in my morning. Well, I've got to allow an extra 10 minutes in case my car door doesn't open.
Hey, quick question. How many cars at your place, Luke?
Two. Right. But
that's interesting.
But I didn't know if Meg had to go out today because she had doctor's appointments and stuff.
Right.
Right? And she was still sleeping. So I've had this problem in the past where I've talked about on the show where I have to rub my keys to create static.
No, it's like we talked about this on the radio. It was like it was either warmth or static electricity. We couldn't work out why that needed to happen. All we knew was that it worked.
It was sometimes in winter after a gig, we'd come outside and if my keys were cold and my car was cold, it wouldn't open my car. Right. It only ever happened when it was cold. It was bizarre. And we eventually worked out that if I rubbed my keys for about a minute, it would then open. Yeah. We couldn't work out why. I think it recharged the battery or something like that quickly. Yeah. Anyway, so I try that, not working.
It recharged the battery?
The static electricity. Because they're those little... You know those little button circle battery. Button?
Right.
We think it actually recharged the battery for a brief.
So it's either heat, static electricity, or movement.
So but
we don't know why. All we know is that it works.
We think we jump started the key.
Yeah.
But hang on, the issue is you can't open the car.
So
but
then
it's still a physical key, right?
No, but in the problem, Lewis and Lewis knows this. There's a massive problem where
this is this, whoever designed your car sparked. Is fucking brain dead.
You open the car door with the key that it's designed for, and the alarm just goes off. So eventually, I've had to disable the outside alarm, so it only goes off inside the car now. So as soon as you lock the door, it's not like pissing off
neighbors. Didn't one time you do that? You had to drive all the way home with the alarm.
With the alarm fucking going. No, it would go off like every 10 minutes, yeah. And I'd be on the highway, and it's so fucking loud. I almost crashed the car once because
it looks like you've stolen it.
I think the moral of the story is I should probably get a new car.
Yeah.
It's like a 2004 Subaru. It needs to go.
Mm.
And so then I unlock it, and then I was like, oh, the alarm hasn't gone off. This is weird. Then I try and start the car. Oh, battery's dead.
Yeah.
And then I look at the light. Meg's left the lights on.
Like Meg.
So
well,
Meg,
she's using your car. You should use hers.
Right. So then I go inside. I go, Meg, can I use your car? You left the car lights on. And I work around. She's like, oh, sorry. And then that put me behind by 10 minutes.
So it's Meg's fault?
No. And then, no. I
was still getting to Ruben?
I think Ruben conspired with Meg to leave the lights on.
Ah. Why? Why'd you do that?
Wait, why would I do that?
Because you hate me being punctual and you're always looking for ways to try and make me late in this show.
But every time you're late, you blame me. So how is it in my advantage?
But you can't deny that since we've moved into the studio, every single time Luke is late, you have been with him.
Yeah,
so that's like, it's 100%. If it was like sometimes...
You're ignoring some of the story.
If sometimes Luke was late and you weren't there, then you might have a case. But at this point, you know, ever since you started carpooling in with Luke, he's been late.
100% of the time, when we're together, you make me late.
Well, statistically, you're right.
Thank you.
That's all we need.
Moving on. No point in going further into it. So then... I meet up with Ruben. Now we like meet up like just before, like, you know, we have a meeting spot, right?
Yeah.
Near his house. And I parked my car.
That was a real Republican debating thing of like, statistically, you're right. And you're right. We don't need to look at any of the factors because the numbers say this and we can't improve society at all. So I win.
So we meet up and then I get in Ruben's car and he goes, I got to get petrol. And I go, oh, for fuck's sake. You've had like, 15 minutes of me trying to open my car to
No, I have a great excuse for this.
You know that Luke, you knew that Luke's car was going to be disabled because you conspired with Meg and then you didn't fill up with petrol.
So I didn't need to fill up with petrol until I had to drive here because Luke didn't want to take Meg's car.
Because it didn't have like the toll thing on it, whereas Ruben's does.
Ah, right.
Yeah. So and I didn't want to move my toll thing because it's like suctioned on permanently.
Yeah, right.
Can you move those off your car? Probably. It'd just be a pain. It's like a one stick thing. One time stick.
You only get one stick?
You only get one stick with those things.
Only one stick. That is, it's in the name. You get one stick. You got to choose wisely.
Yeah.
You
know? And I chose my car and it was not a wise decision.
Well, that's all you get.
Anyway, so I go, Ruben, hey, can we go with your car on the East Link or whatever? Because that's the quickest way to get to Frankston from where we live. And he goes, yeah. And then he goes, oh, there's a Shell up this way and there's a BP up that way. And I'm like, pretty sure there's not a BP on this road up that way. I just went past there. There's definitely no BP.
So, he's fucking with you.
And this is classic Ruben. And then he goes, all right, well, I'm going to the BP. I'm like, I'm telling you.
You know what? I bet it says that on his fucking Android phone app that it goes, there's a BP here, but that was 20 years ago. They got that information
there
today.
There was a BP, but not on the road he was talking about. You know, we then went past it, then had to do a U-turn.
Mm. Well, who was on the map at this point, though, Luke?
Not me.
I think it was
you. I know it's up there. Well, and I was well, in your neighborhood, I trust you.
So he was not only making you late, he was using his phone while driving, trying to kill you in the car.
He was using his brain, which was worse.
It is worse. Yeah.
Brain's you processing the worse than a fucking Android. It fix it.
Don't yell at him for using the map wrong. It's an Android map. It's an Android phone with maps. It doesn't work.
Yeah. No, it was his phone.
What's the app?
He looked it up after.
What's the app?
I looked it up once.
What's the app?
Google Maps.
You looked.
Can't trust Google.
We looked it up. I looked it up once. I realized we'd driven past whatever one you were talking about. I was like, "Hang on, I'll look it up now because Ruben's got no idea, and you know, someone's going to get us here on time."
we were already late at that point.
Can I just say that I woke up at 7 in the fucking morning to clean the house to make sure everyone was ready.
You didn't clean this room. This room was fucked when we got here. That was what we spent the first hour doing.
No, because we had to build the perfect fucking studio space because this is such an important episode that I wanted to get it right.
Right.
And if you guys arrived on time, we all could have done it and it'd be fine.
I've got some great content ahead, but we can't even fucking get to it because I hate doing this show.
Why did we return?
All right. So anyway, long story short, we...
Hang on a second. We do need to move on from this once you finish your story in 50 minutes. You were often late to the Zoom calls. Were you two carpooling to the Zoom calls?
No, and I was never late to the Zoom calls.
It's in your house. It's on your computer.
Yeah.
You don't even need to wear pants.
Can we just have like a little amnesty like type thing going for the next 30 seconds? So everything I say...
Does that mean that for the past 25 minutes you have not been honest?
Oh, no. Never.
He's in a corner.
Anyway, so if I'm being honest,
yeah,
I started off the Zoom calls by setting my alarm 20 minutes before we were going to jump on the call.
Not really enough time.
That's where I started.
That's what I'm saying. It's like, that's like, no shower. No, you have a shower or breakfast.
I was never showering before them.
Yeah.
Hence some of the brutal comments that were left under a few of the episodes.
Yeah.
And I was fine with that. I was like, that's all we might want to, I think I just had that go off. Anyway, that's something I was willing to cop. Then my sleeping pattern got worse. I started, you know, when you set your alarm and you're already like, you should have gone to bed 3 hours ago, but you're like, oh, and that extra 5 minutes. Like, then I started setting it 15. By the last week, I'm pretty sure I actually set an alarm just at 11 a.m.
That is so disrespectful to the other people that work on this show.
But we never
start. That we agree. No, that's...
We never start on time anyway. Plus, like, we never... Like, we plan for like an hour and a half. If I'm 10 minutes late, you guys...
You have to be on half the show.
You guys just talk about the election or some shit for like the first 20 minutes anyway. So I'm like, why am I even here? Sometimes I'm just like, why am I even on this call? Like, I don't want to get... I'm going to learn something.
You know why? Because we wait for 10 minutes for you. We get 10 minutes into a conversation about something unrelated because we can't start planning the show. You rock. We might as well finish it.
Yeah. So anyway, by the end, I was just setting my alarm. Like, if we'd be like 11 a.m. tomorrow, I would just set my alarm for like 11.
Yeah. Okay. Well, that honestly went for much longer than 30 seconds. So I'm holding it against you forever.
Because in my head...
The amnesty's over.
That's fine. But in my head, I was just like, the fact that I'm even rocking up at this point is... insane.
Yeah, look, it's hard to expect you to be timely when you rock up and we start laughing about Scooby-Doo for 40 minutes and then start recording and laugh about it for 20 more minutes
exactly
on the episode.
Believe it or not, in those final weeks, the show like was being held together by Ruben and I, like our brief attempts to plan it.
I'd say by the final episode...
You talked out mentally like a month ago.
Oh, yeah. I wasn't there. I didn't remember it. I'd say really that final episode was held together by Scooby-Doo.
Yeah.
And that's it.
Scooby glue.
I reckon I could hear Keelan laughing from Canberra over that. Scooby glue. That's fucking great. Well, look, okay? Is your car fixed?
Nah, it's fucked.
Oh, do you have a dishwasher?
Nah.
All right. Well, for fuck's sake. Great. Well, I guess we'll, you know, we should start setting it for 10 and I'll see you at fucking 3.
Oh, we have a really important meeting on Wednesday as well. And I like
you can't be late to that one.
I know. I need to get it fixed because we need to drive.
Because we need to record an episode before that very important meeting and then go.
I know. If you had your license, it wouldn't be a fucking problem.
Man, I'm not getting my license. Absolutely not.
The fact that I'm the one that we rely on to get to meetings is insane.
Yeah, that's true. It's really, you know, because if I had my license, 100% I'd be outside your house holding down the horn, pissing off your neighbors because it's funny.
That is a good one.
Yeah.
Now, Lewis, let's get into some content.
Yeah. Oh, really? 28 minutes in, halfway through the fucking episode, we should do one of the things we've written down?
Perhaps.
Yeah, okay. So not only were you late to the episode, you've made us all late to the content of the episode
too.
Well,
to be fair, you wrote Luke's late on the thing, and then I wrote Ruben's fault next to it. So I was planning on throwing him under the bus.
Right, okay. Well, Luke, obviously, you know, you have your merch here. You have been a big... Both of us are obviously very fitness-oriented people, okay? We both care heaps about fitness. Mm-hmm. We just go about it in different ways, you know? It's like religion, you know?
Correct,
lots of religions love God. They just disagree, and sometimes that, you know, has to be resolved with a bit of violence.
It starts wars and actually a kind of...
Beheadings.
Often defeats the original purpose of what religion is supposed to bring out in people.
And I honestly think that's what's happened with us, okay? Mm-hmm. You and I have been arguing and fighting for so long about what way to work out is better. I was very much team actually going to the gym to work out because that's what they're for. And you're very much just going out into the world and working out for free, running.
Well, what bothers me is you're not actually fit. Like, that was always my original argument. Like, what we...
Well, what bothers me is neither are you.
Right.
And this is what I'm getting at. You and me...
It's a strong point.
You and me have been arguing so much over what is the best way to work out...
Yeah.
...that neither of us have been doing either method because we just want to be right so bad. So I have a little proposition. I think you and I, when quarantine started, both made some big calls. We're going to get so fit. World gym's going to happen. Mm. The gym's going to happen. In my defense, the gym got closed.
I've been crushing it lately.
So I switched to the home gym. Okay?
Hard to tell. I did upload a pic of me dressed as Princess Leia and Meg was dressed as Jabba the Hutt. And then Lewis commented, why are there two Jabbas?
That was a good one, wasn't it?
So look, and nice a few people burn, said...
One up Spears.
And you know what sucks? It's like I've been hitting the world gym hard for like a month.
Yeah, so
like
that's growing hard.
I did like... I don't know if it doesn't mean anything to you, but like I did 7 kilometers yesterday at 4:15 kilometer
pace. Pretty good, I assume.
Yeah, it's like not too bad, right? I think someone listening will be like, yeah, not bad.
Yeah, not bad.
Well,
this is what I'm getting at, Luke. You and I both made big calls at the start of quarantine. 2 months left in the year now. This is the 2nd of November when we were recording this. I think that I have a solution here. To really figure out what is the best way to work out and also, right, how to keep us accountable, to actually fucking stand by what we've been saying because we haven't been doing that at all. You know, it's been very on and off. I went hard for a month at the start of quarantine, started looking good, haven't done it since.
Accountability kind of goes against the general mantra of the world gym.
You need to stop this, okay, because you're already weaseling your way out of this. I have a wager for you.
Okay.
And I think this is going to solve all of our problems.
Fine.
And I propose a system. We have 2 months until the end of the year. Mm-hmm. I say today, you and me, get down to our underwear and take a before picture. Okay? And I think we commit to, at the end of the year, you know, after Christmas, posting an after picture, no matter what. And there will be, all right? So there's your accountability. But not only will there be the looming doom of... A side-by-side before and after where potentially both of us look like shit. Or even worse, one of us looks awesome. And the other one looks like shit.
Well,
it could be either one of us.
In the past, if we're just going to look through the history books of the Luke and Lewis show here, you look better. Here's why I don't like this. Because you're all about looks. And that's been my original argument since.
Yep.
Is like, you're an asthmatic. Like, for example, like if there was a fucking zombie apocalypse, right? Mm-hmm. You'd be the last person I would want to hang out with. You try and run down the street, you're fucked.
Well, mate, you're going to die. I've got a plan. Back to front. It's all done. I'm sweet.
Okay. Anyway, I'm just saying like in an actual, like you couldn't do like a tough mutter. Because you wouldn't have the aerobic ability to like actually run 2 kilometers.
Yeah. So you
might look better in a photo, but I would say that's not actually
I would say that me right now,
because I'd have to change my style of fitness.
Me right now running is like someone who's a week into their COVID symptoms going up the stairs.
Yes.
Yeah.
That's always been the case.
A young person, so they're not going to die, but they're struggling.
Yeah. Like 2017, Lewis had COVID.
Yeah.
Like running up that hill in New Zealand.
Oh, yeah.
That was, you had a lot of symptoms going well before the virus hit
our shores. Yeah, I was patient zero running up that hill. You know, my asthma got so bad it mutated.
Yes.
So there's that. Okay. And before you say,
can I just say,
I'm open to modifications of this.
Right. Because at the moment it definitely like swings in your favor because you go for like muscles and like the way you look. I have like mates that are national runners and they just get on the piss a bit.
Yeah.
But like they're some of the fittest people in the country.
You just couldn't still tell got a dad bod. Yeah. Shirt off. Yeah. 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 Okay. But,
so Luke, like it depends what we're talking about. What's fitness to you?
Just first of all, it's less about the contrast between you than it is the contrast between the before
your
and
former
after.
Self.
But what I'm trying to backpedal myself out of here, Ruben, is I'm going to say like, can I do like, because I judge my performance
we
off
can
like
add
actual
in that.
Performance.
Let's add in that, okay?
Right? Like times.
So
and
we'll do both. We'll have the before pictures and for me it'll be lifts, for you it'll be running times.
Okay.
And then we'll post them. And then also...
I should look better, theoretically, if I actually really try.
I think...
Problem
yeah.
is my diet and...
You'll look better.
You know,
yeah.
Man, it's... Yeah, I was saying on my podcast... The silly season has begun.
Look, I'm talking about hypothetically, I haven't even gotten to the rest yes. of the idea. Ruben and I planned this out. It's a great idea. All I'm hearing from you is excuses. Let me finish.
Okay.
So there's the after pictures and the after stats that we've added in. Okay. Also, there will be a point system. Okay. And now I've forgotten. What we win, we decided on that. I forgot it. My brain doesn't work. I'll explain the system and then yep. Ruben has the prize in his brain because he's not a fucking idiot. So there's a point system to keep us accountable. Ideally, in a perfect world, how many times a week do you want to run? In the perfect world where you're not a piece of shit.
Five.
5 days.
I've been doing four, but
I like that. Five. I also want to work out 5 days a week. So I love that.
Okay.
So I propose a system that keeps us accountable. Okay. To the Luke and Lewis story, that every day you work out is 1 point for the week. However, if you do not work out a minimum of 3 points, you lose all your points. So if you do 1 day here, 1 day there, 0 points for the week, you're eliminated.
But it's just an honesty system.
No, you got to post a photo of you to the Luke and Lewis story, and the listeners will hold us accountable.
I'm going to have to do a post run so you can tell that I'm fucked because yep. I could just dress up in my running clothes.
Ruben...
Because I don't take my phone with me on the run. I have like a watch and...
Bluetooth Ruben's going to be the official judge of this competition, and if he detects any suspicious workouts, he will be interrogated on the show.
I think you can tell after someone's worked out.
I think you can.
You can tell after I've run.
That's why you better not bloody cheat.
I wasn't planning on it.
Yeah. No, but just to alleviate everyone's fears, because there is a point system, there's a prize.
It seems like a lot of effort to like post about it. Like again, it's
well, maybe you need to just send a thing to Ruben
you're a poser, dude. Like then you like posting about your workouts, but in the world gym, we just get it done and we don't fucking tell everyone about it.
Okay, we'll keep track of it. Okay, you know.
Okay.
It's an honesty.
You can look on my watch. Yeah, Garmin keeps track of it. Okay.
But you got to text Ruben. Say, hey mate, just smashed a workout.
Send you pictures of my watch if you want.
I look forward to it.
You know what? How about that? So it's blind once a week.
Yeah, because
we text Ruben how many workouts we've done.
No one wants to see us fucking working out every day on a story.
That will get a little bit exhausting.
That's so annoying for 8 weeks. Yeah. Fuck okay. That.
Well, maybe once a week we got to post just so people know it's happening. How about every time we work out, we text Ruben. He tallies it up, and then at the end of the week, he goes,
"You want to do this?
Luke's score is this. Lewis's score is that.
Mm-hmm.
That's good."
Yep.
Okay. And so then at the end, right? So not only is there there's a before and after photo and stats posted at the end of the year, whoever has the most workout points will win.
So it's not that you win if you have the most points.
What's great about this, I've completely forgotten what Ruben and I decided, so I'm a little bit excited to find out what the prize is too.
And it was your idea.
Yeah, it was. Yeah, I can't remember. It could have been Ruben's idea. It could have been mine.
There's a conversion rate that we'll have to figure out, but essentially you cash in your points for editing time in Photoshop.
For the after photo.
But I don't know how to use Photoshop.
Talked about this. Ruben's going to be the Photoshop guy. So the level of Photoshop skill will be the same. Ruben's not a pro.
This defeats the whole fucking bet.
Well, then you better work out.
If we're allowed to edit it, what's the point of fucking doing the after photo edited?
The stats.
But you won't. If you are working out, you then won't need to edit it. It defeats the point. You haven't thought about this much.
Yeah, it's just an extra leg up.
Oh,
it's an
you
incentive.
Can like edit the other person to be fat.
If you want, it's your time.
Oh, I'd spend it all on you.
You've earned the points, you know?
I don't like that bit. I think if we're going to do a before and after, you have to live with the shame or the thing of Photoshopping.
Well, then we need to figure out what are we doing with the points. I like the idea of converting them to a reward. The other idea I had was obviously... Luke and Lewis is not making a profit at all. However, I think there is some small room in the budget. Ruben gets paid. Keelan gets paid. You and me, we don't get paid. I think there's a little bit of room in the budget to pay one of us for the year.
One Christmas bonus
that only one of us gets, and we have to earn it with points.
Ooh. Now you've got me interested.
Yeah.
Now there is financial incentive. And we all know how both of us react to financial incentive. Exhibit A, your head. And my head last week.
How many points can you get in a week?
Mm-hmm.
If you, let's five. Say, five Five's points a week.
So you, just you, like, you can do more. You can get
the
20.
Problem with 40, this is...
40. So every 10 points is $100?
I don't want to, like, poo-poo the idea because I like it. But there is, like, a scaling issue of, like, what's considered, like, is sometimes I run 10 kilometers, some days I run 5 kilometers.
There needs to be a...
Both are just 1 point.
I think a workout is a workout. There is a minimum workout.
You got to do half an hour minimum.
Yeah, minimum. Half hour. That's a workout.
Like the government recommended, like, how much you should work out.
And you have
day.
To be breathing pretty minimum. Hard by the end.
Yeah, that's my heart rate got to 196 2 days
You're
ago.
You're going
to
die.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I ran 3 kilometers at 350 pace, and it's been the first time in a while. Mm. And someone screamed, "Love the mullet," at me. And I don't even think they were a fan of our show.
That's good.
So that's awesome. Oh, and another thing I wanted to bring up happened on my...
So you're down with the bet?
Yeah. Oh, we can't shake hands.
Oh. You're on.
Boom. All right. So is
can't
it
wait
last
to
show
spend
of the
my
year?
Bonus.
Is it the Loogies?
Yes.
The results are revealed at the Loogies?
Yeah, I like
what about
that.
We do like a UFC strip down at the Loogies?
Yeah, that is good. Yeah, where we weigh...
It's a bit rude, but we were going to try and hopefully by that stage have some kind of a studio audience. We invite everyone to your house and we just get our pants off.
We've got scales in the bathroom.
Okay, that's fun. Well, again, I'm not really trying to lose weight because I am...
Oh, you should be.
That's the thing. I lost half a kilo. Because I like get skinny fat.
Half a kilo. Like a helicopter
Did
worth
I say
of
helo
then? He said helo. Jeez, you must have been stacking it on in quarantine. That's like 500 kilos.
Fat on my brain. Yeah, I lost half a kilo.
Yeah.
But I think I just fluctuate. It just usually depends on water weight. I'm pretty much 75 all the time. And I think if I actually got fit, I'd be heavier.
I put on like 2 or 3 kilos, which is my goal.
Like,
and then I just lost 2.
I could be a chunky 77, but I could be a muscly 77. If that's the issue with guys and weight loss. It's never like it's anyone really.
Yeah.
I don't think weight loss is
Well, not
always,
everyone needs to lose weight.
Yeah, I don't like weight loss being a fitness goal really ever. It should just be like...
Should be performance and aesthetics.
Yeah, and then like looking better than your mate in a photo.
Yeah.
I've already said, I said on my podcast that I actually set a fitness goal of my own, just a personal fitness goal. It doesn't have anything to do with this bet, but I guess it can be a part of it. I think I promised at one point that again, this was September talk.
There was a lot of yapping.
And I said at one point, I reckon the rig will be sorted by mid-November. Oof. And that's quickly approaching.
Was that 2 weeks
that's
away?
2 weeks away.
Yeah, good luck.
And then I said... I'm probably going to debut the rig on Instagram early December.
Okay.
Just in time for
might have to postpone that.
I think I'll postpone that for this bet because now I'm really going to crank it up. Man, New Year's Eve, I'll be looking like a fucking schneck.
I think we both, our problem is from the start, we weren't competing with each other. So why the fuck would you try at all? You know, now it's on.
Yeah. I will never really work hard to better myself, but to prove a point, absolutely.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I'm going to look like shit in February, but like in January, I'll be coming off a great couple of months of fitness.
Yeah.
My personal fitness goal, though, however, I just said till the end of summer, my personal fitness goal is to be on the receiving end of an organic wolf whistle.
Really?
If it's a tradie, and it can't be ironic because I've been ironically wolf whistled before and it hurt my feelings.
When?
Just running past like a work site, and then you're going hard, but they can tell you're going hard, but you're not physically in your peak.
Yeah.
And they yell, "Run, Forrest, run."
Yeah.
You give them the finger and then someone wolf whistles.
You know why that happened to you? Because it became less funny and more mean to do it to fat people.
Yeah. So now they just pick on people trying their best.
Yeah. That used to be super normal, yelling shit at fat people. And then everyone, I feel like a lot of people like, well, hang on, they're trying.
So that's
Whereas
why
yelling at like someone who's doesn't have a shit rig but definitely doesn't have a good one. That's pretty funny.
And to be honest, I would have been doing the same thing if I.
That's so Australia. Yeah. Look at him; he's trying. bettering himself. Dork, have a beer.
It's actually
come
like
down into
happened.
The mud with me. That's Australia.
It is. And that's the thing, I ran past that. I wasn't even mad about it. I was just kind of mad that I wasn't having a beer with them. so that's my goal. Do you reckon it's possible? It's completely under my control. But if I'm looking good enough, in 2020, it's hard to get a wolf whistle.
It's difficult. You're not supposed to wolf whistle people. My personal one is to get an organic compliment in a t-shirt from someone that I kind of know. It can't be girlfriend, close friend. You boys are all out. It has to be like a friendly acquaintance.
No one here was going to do that.
That happens when you start working out and you look a little bit better. Closest people to you are the first ones to notice, you know. But when you're in a t-shirt and it's someone that you kind of know and they go, you been working out? That's real progress.
Meg said to me a couple of days ago, you look a little less grinchy.
Me?
Me.
You.
Yeah, me. She goes to me.
I thought because I had green hair.
Oh, no, because I've got a shit rig.
Oh, okay. Oh, so she wasn't talking about hair, like she was talking
Grinch.
About belly.
Yeah, I look like the Grinch mid-lockdown.
That's good, but that doesn't count. See, if someone that we'd seen 4 months ago and you got along really well with them.
You actually look way more Grinchy now than you ever have.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, because particularly you dyed your hair for Halloween, didn't you?
Yeah, so now it's more green. Mm. I sprayed it all green. It hasn't all properly come out.
You've just been a blue joker.
That's what I wanted to do, but Jazz was like, no, he's got green hair. I said, whatever. Yeah. She really wanted to do it properly.
Mm. I saw that. So did you guys do a Halloween by yourself?
We did Halloween in the house. So it was fun.
But do you can invite like another couple over? Do you have
couple
we don't
friends? Know any couples in Frankston.
Yeah, in 25.
Because Keel and Phoebe were busy.
Yeah, yeah. Yes. eat fresh.
Yeah.
Come
that's
fresh.
Disgusting. Sorry. I hated seeing that. Really
and
told
I, you know what it's really funny is that he texts me, not you.
Oh, because he knows that I wouldn't appreciate that. It's like, and Mike also texts you and not me about being a freshly cummed Mike.
I think it's a good one.
Obviously, you're giving off, let me know if you've cum vibes.
No, I'm giving off, like, tell me if it's fresh vibes. I don't want to know if it's, like, gross.
You know, so what would take that from kind of a good one, I guess, like, to completely not on would be if they were by themselves at the time.
Yeah, yeah. I don't want to know, like, oh, man, just had a stale cum. Oh, don't tell me that.
Yeah.
You know, but if it comes out fresh.
Just had a great wank. That's a bit pushing
that's
the boundary.
Too much.
A bit much?
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
But happy to hear about. I'm not happy about
had
it.
A
I just,
sick route.
I just think it's good content for the show, mainly. Yeah. As soon as Keelan sent me that, I went, well, you've just made now 6,000 other people.
So, so if like
8,000, how many people listen to this now? It's gone up a lot.
Yeah. That's what I'm saying. It's the biggest it's ever been. Unfortunately.
Yeah, and plus think of the people that will listen to this maybe in a couple of years time. Now they know about Keelan's fresh cum. Hey, what's up? 2022 people.
That is weird. Do you ever think about that? Like how, you know, 20 years from now,
it just might be people
if the internet's
in.
Still around, this will probably still be up somewhere. Mm. You know, you might be dead.
Maybe.
Probably.
People are like, maybe you shouldn't have had that beer.
Yeah.
Or something.
Yeah.
I hope not. I hope that's not.
So with this one, like it's got to be, you have to have had sexual intercourse. You have to be a pretty good mate and probably an employee.
What are we talking about now?
Just letting you know if you had a fat cum.
Oh, okay. Fat cum or a fresh cum?
Fresh cum. Whatever.
All right, fat cum.
It's your rules, mate. I'm not up for any type of cum information. So if people listening to this show, they just had a root and they sent you a snap about it, that's not on?
I reckon, like, if Keelan had wanked on the regional tour, that would have been a fat cum.
That is disgusting. And that's enough. And we've reached the climax.
And
literally.
I had stopped and you kept going.
Yeah.
You know?
That's what she said.
That's what Phoebe said.
Well, no, that is absolutely not on because that's an employee's girlfriend. So
we've met a few times. I would say acquaintance.
No, you're not on that level at all. Absolutely not. I'm distancing myself from this half of the show.
That's good. We're supposed to be distancing anyway. Yeah. So
socially and officially.
Well, I transitioned into Halloween because that's written down, and then you just went right back into calm.
Straight back to calm.
I
like
got
a bit
of
anarchy, maybe. I'm the Joker.
How was your Halloween?
Yeah, it was sick.
You had a good cum. Bit of a spooky cum.
No.
I know for a fact, I know this is way over the line, but I know you and Jazz dressed up as Harley Quinn and the Joker, I know for a fact you were like, keep it on. But we're here now, so I might as well just ask.
Well, we're not talking about it.
Okay, fine.
There's no nothing to
You don't have
discuss.
To answer that.
You
know, I just know. I already know. That's I because you were like, yeah, she wanted me to go green for some reason. I was like, well, there's only one way. You know, she wanted that true Joker experience. So you guys were just doing, that's what I don't get. You were just doing it for you two.
Yeah, it was great. Did you watch movie? It was a good idea in quarantine. We decided, originally we were going to like surprise each other with costumes for Halloween. Cool idea. Buy costumes online. You don't know what you're getting. And then we rock up together. But then we kind of both worked out that she'd picked Harley and I'd picked the Joker just organically. And then we were like, oh, well, let's just do it really properly. Went to a costume shop, dressed up. She did makeup. Mm-hmm. It was great fun.
You didn't like post any pics or anything, so it's just for you.
Yeah.
You didn't like that's a good I would say that's good content for your Instagram. Like you with blue hair.
I think I might post a photo
as the
tonight.
Joker. It's you
a
bit probably late. Should.
Yeah.
Like I would say that's
but that was just, it wasn't for Instagram, it was for us.
Yeah, and then what good did fun. You do? Did you watch a scary movie?
Yeah, we watched
I can just picture you guys dressed up and there's the initial like, that looks cool. It looks cool. Then you're like so we just sit on the couch and watch the movie.
It was a bit of that, yeah. It was kind of like 2 hours of makeup and then, take some photos and then, all right, face is a bit itchy.
Yeah.
You know?
And then just less comfortable
watch
for the
a movie.
Rest of the evening.
We did watch a movie. Jazz was like, Jazz hates scary movies. We watched the first time Jazz and I ever watched a scary movie, like personally and together, never really watched a full horror film. We picked The Conjuring. Which is
the
worst
one.
Place to start.
The new one?
No, the original The Conjuring.
Oh, the original's... There's a really... Okay.
The one with like the Jewish religious guy.
Right.
The rabbi.
Fucking, I think we don't boil today.
No, we won't boil.
We'll save
we'll
that for
do
next
this
time.
And then we'll...
Ruben's just gesturing us that we're still doing the last idea and it requires a mystery boiling of water.
Yeah, Ruben has to boil the kettle. So Ruben, can you remember the next episode? Remember to boil the kettle at the start of the episode. Because unfortunately, we spent so long arguing about who was late for what reason that now we can't do the kettle bit.
No problem. It's already noted.
Thanks,
don't need
mate.
To write it down.
Brilliant. Great. I'd appreciate it if you did write it down. Can't trust your memory.
Can't trust my memory.
Yeah, well, you were saying a lot of things like, I didn't make Luke late. And it just feel like it doesn't reflect reality.
I'll write it down.
I think you're losing that.
Yeah,
a little bit.
So we picked The Conjuring the first time ever. And we, both of us, were terrified. Stayed up all night, freaked out. It was bad, especially because we were house-sitting at the time, so it wasn't our house.
This was ages ago.
Years back, okay. So, and we haven't watched a scary film since. Jazz was like, it's Halloween, I want to watch a scary movie. And I was like, well, you remember what happened last time. I don't think either of us are very good with scary films, so we should start slow. I picked a nice little murder thriller on Netflix.
Yeah, do a thriller. Do like a Paranormal Activity or like not something completely horror.
Yeah, yeah. Like something with a jump scare and that's it. Something dip your toes in. Jazz goes, No, I've done my research. I want to watch The Ring. I said, what are you doing, bitch?
Is that the one?
You
want to
watch this one of the scariest films ever.
With the girl and she's got straightened black hair and she's in the white?
Yeah, kind of known as one of the scarier films of its time.
Isn't that still old, though?
No, when I watched it, it didn't strike me as old. It struck me as terrifying.
I
think the Japanese version came out in the 90s.
Some of those, I haven't watched a lot of horror in my time. Like, we used to have to study in for media in high school. I remember we used to watch like those 90s corny ones of like Scream.
Yeah, because they can't traumatize kids.
I Knew What You Did Last Summer. And they're kind of just like, who's the killer kind of movies.
Yeah.
But I haven't watched any crazy ones. I've watched The It wasn't that scary. Is that a horror movie?
I'd say it's like a thriller suspense.
It's a thriller. Is it or the it?
It. The it.
I don't know.
The IT crowd.
The IT crowd. That's scary.
That is too.
When he turns it off and on again. Whoa.
Yeah. Fucking. So we watched The Ring and I've spent ages going, Jazz, when you start less scary, we can't go all the way in The Ring. And anyway, I was fine. She hasn't slept for 2 days. Properly. She keeps thinking about the monster.
Does it
the girl.
Sleep under your bed or something?
Not really.
But
it's
so
it's,
much behind
it's,
the
it's
scenes.
It's less scary today because it was like a TV thing. It's on your TV. And I'm like, I'm safe. It's not plugged in. Who the fuck watches TV?
Yeah. It's just one of those things where there's so much like behind the scenes, particularly the old ones. Like, you know who like the actress is. There's behind the scenes photos of them filming it.
Mm.
That's the thing that mentally I go, right, well, that's, you know, 20 people were behind the camera. They were trying to make...
Yeah, knowing too much about pre-production and why... and camera angles and why they've done things often ruins the experience of a film. You have to turn that part of your brain off.
But those new ones, I'm pretty sure I've seen bits of it. I've seen this horrible bit. It was, I think it's the new Conjuring. Something pops up in the mirror and holy fuck.
The guy that directs the Conjuring films is some freak horror director who did the I think the Conjuring was his first big horror one, and it was so fucking scary that they were like, do six more. And he's just been doing this whole Conjuring scary film universe. It's like the Marvel of terrifying shit your pants films.
We played on the
James
stream.
Wan or something.
James Wan, yeah, correct.
We played on a stream Friday night, or the night before Halloween. We did like a Halloween stream. We played Outlast 2. And video games are a strange one because it's animated horror, so it's definitely nowhere near as scary as real people portraying it.
I think, depending on the game,
playing it
you're
by
in
yourself,
it, so I think it's scarier.
That's an added element.
If
but
the lights are off in your house and you're by yourself, much scarier than a film, I think.
Those horror games are just based around one thing happening every 5 to 10 minutes and nothing happening in the meantime.
Yeah. Your phone's on too. Great. Anyway. Turn mine off. Well, it doesn't matter. The episode's pretty much over.
All right. Anyway, there was a lot of jump scares, and it wasn't too bad. It was just jump scares. Like, there'd be big bangs.
That's not scary.
And
atmosphere things. Is the real scary bit of a game.
It's one of those games where, like, you're in this abandoned high school, and there's this big corridor, and it's full of lockers. And
is that based on one of Ruben's TikToks?
Yeah.
Oh, no, sorry. You said abandoned?
Yeah. Mind. He likes to do it.
He only does real schools.
You know, like, ones with the locker doors? Like,
yeah.
And then, like, there was this person at the end of the corridor. It's one of those ones where you're walking through a bunch of closed lockers. So I'm just walking down the hall and everyone's watching the stream and I'm like, fuck, it's just... So my tactic was just attack it with pace. It's like the honey badger method. Just hit it with pace and you just, like, run down the corridor. So if anything jumps out, you're already running. You're already running. Like, it doesn't matter.
Yeah, those horror games are...
You don't walk.
The best experience, never hitting the sprint button.
Yes. Walking through them is like how you're very supposed scary. To play them. But I was just like, nope, go. I just want to be out of here.
Yeah.
But every scene is like, just get to the next checkpoint. And then I'm not a fan of the genre, to be honest. I don't like the feeling of intentionally being distressed.
I don't know why
people are into it.
Yeah. After we watched The Ring, the night after, when we were because we were taking photos of us wearing the costumes, Jazz set up a big black ring light to head height, right? So anyway, we take the photos and then we have a shower, we take off the makeup, it's hours later, and then she goes to get a glass of water in the dark kitchen with the fucking human-shaped black thing that looks just like the girl, and she goes, ah! She like full-on screams at like, you know, midnight. And then I'm fucking freaked out because I think, you know, that she things come out of the fucking TV and got Jazz.
Yeah.
So that was a good one.
I just don't understand it. It's always just like whenever you're talking about people and they go, oh, and then afterwards I shut myself for 3 days. And it's like,
that's the
why did you do that?
I like watching the film. And then if I could turn the scary bit off when the film ends, I'd love it. But I can't do that. I am, however, reading the book of The Ring that it's based off.
We've talked about this before on the podcast really early on. Do you ever have a spooky read? I think I've already asked you this on the podcast.
No, you have asked me this. I've never... There's no jump scares. It's just, yes, I have had a spooky read though. Heart-Shaped Box by Joe Hill. Fucking terrifying.
Just so funny to like, be reading a book in the middle. Oh!
No, you just read it. And like literally the first 30 pages of Heart-Shaped Box, I'm literally going there going, but this is spooky. I kind of want to stop reading.
Wow.
Never jump though.
To create like an atmosphere and a world where in your imagination,
so
you're like spooking yourself.
Yeah, because it's yourself. There's nothing there other than words. You're scaring yourself. So
yeah, but there's no like jump scares like where you jump to the next paragraph and it's like bang and you're like, whoa.
The only time I've said it on the show before, I was reading a book with my grandma once, separate books, obviously.
Yeah.
And then she just goes,
oh yeah.
And I was like, what happened? She goes, he pulled out a knife. And I was like, fuck. Must be a good book. I've never made a noise. No. I've probably farted once reading a book, but okay. I would say that's unrelated.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, I've never like reading a Dr. Seuss book and then just run farted.
Oh, fuck, he's wearing a hat.
Shit, farted.
That's crazy. This bloke's got fucking green ham on him. Yeah.
Anyway, guys, I think that's the end of the show.
That's it.
We should say what's happening. We're back. Keelan's in Canberra for, we don't really know how long. He was just going crazy living by himself. And we said, look, just go. It'll probably still be locked down. And then by the time you come back, it'll be open. He locked in the trip next day. Melbourne's open. So whatever, that kind of sucks. But we have Ruben here taking over Keelan's job. We'll probably maybe call Keelan at some point, check in on Canberra, probably after he's done with all the coming.
Well, he's got 2 weeks of quarantine. There's nothing. I called him this morning on the way here, and he's not doing anything. I'm like, what have you been up to? He's like, 14 days of quarantine. Not much.
True. He actually flew to quarantine.
Yes.
So he has it worse than we do now.
Yes.
Sucked in. That's great. He extended his quarantine by 2 weeks.
We'll maybe check in maybe the end of quarantine to just catch up on how the last 2 weeks was, because I don't think a lot has happened.
Yeah, because he's not even in his room. We're back in studio. We're going to be staying here for as long as it is safe to do so. We would really, really appreciate you guys sharing the show around. Share the new clips. We have a clips channel on YouTube that'll have all of the in-studio clips that look a lot nicer than the Zoom. And we're back, and hopefully, fingers crossed, it'll stay this way. So follow the rules so that can happen. But Luke and Lewis is fucking back.
Not for your personal safety or the livelihoods of your loved ones.
Just for our dumb show.
So Luke and Lewis can continue in the best format possible.
Yes, absolutely. All right. We'll talk to you guys in a couple of days. Oh, and good luck with the election, America. I think that's happening today. But, good luck.
Yeah.
Bye.